Here I am. What did you need?
I'm Ronnie Shaw, Commonwealth Minuteman. At least I was. Back before Joe Becker got himself killed and the idiots took over.
Glad to meet you. We can use some more veterans around here.
Well, you're right about that. I feel like some of these you've got still may need their diapers changed.
I'd still like to hear what you came to talk to me about.
Heard you were trying to get the Minutemen back on their feet. Thought I'd come see the new general for myself. So what's your story? What makes you think anybody even wants the Minutemen back?
The Minutemen are the good guys again. People are starting to realize that.
I've heard some good things. Wouldn't be here otherwise. Now that I'm here, I can see you really need my help.
Are you offering to rejoin?
I guess I am, but first things first. I'm probably the only one who still remembers this, but the castle's armory was located in the West Bastion. All of our best equipment was stored in there. Weapons, ammo, schematics, you name it. Come on.
9 a.m. here at Radio Freedom. Nothing new to report. Keep it tuned here for Minutemen Alerts.
Good. Looks like it might still be intact. Door still sealed. Bastion hasn't collapsed. Trick now is finding a way in.
I hope you have an idea.
Of course I do. If you can't go through, go around. Let's have a look at the northeast bastion. Tunnel leading from here to the armory. This tunnel's blocked by this rubble. We'll have to find some way to clear it.
This is Radio Freedom, broadcasting all day, all across the Commonwealth. All quiet, which is how we like it. Stay safe out there, people.
up, General. My night vision ain't what it used to be. United we stand. Yeah, that was it. Excellent. The armory's still intact. Everything we need, just waiting for us. You found the schematics for building artillery, right?
I have to admit, Ronnie, having artillery would help out quite a bit.
Oh, we used to rain down fire on Deathclaws and super mutants alike. It was a glorious thing. All right, let's get going. Don't forget to grab some smoke grenades, too. Like you've got everything we need. As soon as you get some artillery built, we'll do a test fire to calibrate it.
are tuned to Radio Freedom, voice of the Minutemen. All quiet, which is how we like it. Stay safe out there.
Darn, it's good to see artillery here again.
Stay
safe. Now, here's the thing about the big guns. They can't fire at anything too close, but their range is impressive. That's what the smoke grenades are for. Toss one of those at the bad guys. If we have artillery in range, we'll confirm over the radio and target our fire on your smoke. But first, we better do a test fire. Make sure we're hitting what we're aiming at. You see that little building over there? We'll use that for our aiming point. Keep your radio on and tuned to Radio Freedom so we can confirm we're ready.
All right, General, if you can hear me, we're ready. Toss one of those smoke grenades into the target area and we'll start the test fire. Your smoke on the target. You might want to stand back. You know, just in case. that look good from here. You've now got artillery support. Use it wisely, General.
A second. I got something I want to say to you.
Of course. What's on your mind?
Appreciate it. We've been on the road together for a while. And we've taken some hard knocks. But through all that crap, I notice you've always been sticking by me. You know, watching me back and making sure I don't do anything stupid. I think maybe it's time to tell you a little bit about who you're traveling with. There's no reason for us to keep acting like we're strangers.
I appreciate your trust.
Well, you're the first to earn it. It all starts with two wastes of humanity, I suppose you could call me parents. I'm convinced I was a mistake, because I can't remember a single moment that they treated me like their daughter. I was yelled at and beaten. Everything I did was wrong. Nothing but a nuisance in their eyes. The whole time I was telling myself that they had to love me, even if it was just the tiniest bit, because they never kicked me out. Then me 18th birthday arrived. And I found out why they kept me around. They slapped a shock collar around me neck and sold me to slavers. They didn't even care enough about me to say goodbye. 18 years of suffering through that shite, and all I was worth to them was a pocket full of caps.
My God, I'm so sorry.
Thanks. But there is more to the story. It would be easy to blame me charming personality on me parents, but they didn't make me this way. I did. I was with those slavers for 5 years. Roughest five of me goddamn life. The things they made me do. The way they use me for their amusement. It sickens me to me stomach even thinking about it. But I bided me time and learned to use their own methods against them. Stealing a few caps out of a sleeping man's pocket is a piece of cake. As long as you don't get greedy.
2 a.m. here at Radio Freedom. Nothing to report at the moment. Stay tuned for updates.
I can't even imagine having to go through something like that.
You think that's low? Just wait. The story gets much worse. It took every ounce of patience I had. But after 5 years, I had finally pocketed enough to buy my own way out of there. But instead of heading off to try and repair the shambles of me life, I gave in to me rage and I headed home. You can imagine the look on me parents' faces when I kicked open their door. What you can't imagine is what they looked like after. After I emptied me gun into them.
Sounds like justice to me.
Was it justice? Or was it murder? When I close me eyes, all I can see is their faces twisted with fear. And then my mind starts wandering and I start judging myself. And it's ripping me the fuck apart. You think I inject myself with all that shite and drink myself drunk because I'm a tough Irish girl? I do it so I can forget and move on with my miserable life. So there you are. The entire flawed package known as CAIT. Stripped bare for your perusal.
Why judge yourself?
My parents sold me into slavery. But did they deserve to die for it? Yeah, I took some hard knocks as I was growing up. But they fed me and kept me from glowing with rads. This is the kind of crap that starts me mind wandering and drives me literally to drink. I guess I'm just waiting to hear what you think of me now.
I'm proud of you.
I knew I was taking a chance telling you all this. But I never expected you to say you were proud of me. I think I needed to hear that from you. Thank you.
I'm always here for you, CAIT. There's nothing you can say that would ever change that.
Well, that's not what I expected you to say. Sorry. I didn't realize you cared that much about me. And here I thought I was being stupid, bothering you with me problems. It feels good to know if I need you, you'll be there for me. And I'll always be there for you, too.
All across the Commonwealth. Nothing to report. Stay safe out there, everyone.
Thank you. I've got to hand it to you, General. You've really turned things around for the Minutemen. I never thought I'd see the day that the Minutemen had artillery support again. We should see about building them at all our settlements to expand our coverage. And Ronnie Shaw returns. She's something else, isn't she?
Yeah, she definitely knows how to take charge.
Ha, that's a bit of an understatement from what I hear. I'd heard stories about her from the old-timers, but I didn't know she was still around. The fact that she's come back to the Minutemen means we must be doing something right. I'll let you know if I hear of any settlements that need our help. In the meantime, make sure to offer help to anyone that needs it. That can only help our cause.
Like it's in working order.
Hope this rain lets up soon.
You're tied to this place, kid. Your energy.
I used to live here. A long time ago.
Ah, but the distant past ain't so distant for you. The sight can help?
Here. Already have some.
Like a little kick yourself. You're on the trail of the man who took your boy. I see a house, but there's another way.
Uh-huh. Ooh.
Got it.
Our little sanctuary revival project has really helped. It takes my mind off things.
General?
Yeah? Let's move quick. This area isn't agreeing with us.
Hey there.
Please, just... wait. You're not with the Gunners. Are you here to help us out?
I'm here to help. What's the problem?
It's the Gunners. We caught a group.
Uh-huh.
They ran off. If you can help us...
It's over. For now.
something's out there.
You're dead. Don't forget what you've done for us.
What do you need, General?
Well, that's a few gunners that won't be attacking our settlements anytime soon.
When we all work together, the bad guys don't stand a chance.